knew that if I didn't say it, that I would do it. And I just didn't want to be alive anymore.
That shocking statement coming from Meghan Markle in a powerful and riveting interview between the Sussexes and Oprah Winfrey, airing last night right here on Channel 3. The Duchess admitted she was having suicidal thoughts while living in England. She said she tried to get help, but was told it wouldn't look good for the royal family. For more on how to destigmatize mental illness, we are joined by Ryan Guterl, the clinical director at Retreat Behavioral Health in New Haven. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you. I'm happy to join. So I got to watch that last night, and it's very important, I think, to talk about what people are experiencing. Stigma is something that is probably impacted by people across the nation and across the world. And it's one of those things where people are asking, what can we do? And typically it's one of those things where number one is this, people believe it should be kept a secret. It's something that shouldn't be discussed. Mental illness in general is something that isn't widely accepted still to this day. And the most important thing that to recognize here is that most people feel alone. They feel trapped. Even in that interview, I remember she had said that she felt trapped and alone, and she had no one to turn to. And so that's a huge stigma that's associated with mental illness, that you are alone. And people ask the question, how can family members be of support? How can they be of help? The main thing to remember is that because of the fact they don't feel supported is being having a platform where they can be heard, where they feel supported, where they're not alone and they're not the only ones are the most important things to remember when supporting your loved ones.
I think so many of us were shocked by some of the revelations that she revealed, and it's probably a misrepresentation. Sometimes you think she's a princess, she must be happy, and that, you know, was not the case. What do you think could her talking about this issue do for others who may need help? Because sometimes people need help, but they're disguising it with smiles.
Sure. It's interesting because you would assume that someone in that role must be a happy individual. And the reality is that no matter what you're doing in your life, you can have stress no matter how much success you have. And that's probably one of the most important things to remember, because I think it's important to know that even in the role that she's had, she's probably had very similar life experiences as other people. And it could be, you know, the trauma she's experienced. It could be the fact that she's not being heard by the people who are supposed to love and support her the most. So in all honesty, no matter what walk of life you're in, typically you'll have more in common with people than you realize. And that begins to take away some of that stigma.
Honestly, so well said, and this is such an important topic, so I do hope we have you on again soon. Ryan Guterl from Retreat Behavioral Health in New Haven, thank you so much for your insight. We appreciate it.